Are you there? Yes. Hello, everyone. Have a very happy Monday. So today we have a new guest with us, Jaisal Mehta. He is Assistant Professor of Design at NMIMS School of Design. They are knowledge partner with us at the next Eduthon. So, अब हमने बहुत चर्चा कर ली कि एजुकेशन क्या है, एजुकेशन में पॉलिसी क्या है, फिर एजुकेशन में इनोवेशन कैसे लाना है. वी ऑल्सो गॉट समबडी फ्रॉम इनोवेशन इकोसिस्टम फॉर यू. नाउ विथ दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन वी आर ब्रिजिंग द गैप बिटवीन टू एजुकेशन एंड इनोवेशन. So, Jaisal teaches design. We will understand from him what is design, what is design thinking, which is a buzzword these days, right? So, and how to apply design thinking in the context of education. Hi, Jaisal.
Hello. Hi, Sharmari. So nice.
Welcome to Coffee Conversations.
Absolutely.
Today, both of us have coffee.
Yes. Coffee is necessary to function on Monday.
Right. So we will take your questions also. You can just type them in the comment box and let us know about your questions. But first we will understand from Jaisal, what is School of Design doing and what is Jaisal Mehta teaching?
Okay, so the School of Design is... it's under the University of NMIMS, NMIMS University. We are a three-year-old school. So we still don't, our first batch will graduate this year.
Okay.
We're on their projects and internships right now in, as we speak. And so we are a relatively new and young school, but we are doing a very different kind of course compared to the other design schools in that design is anyway a transdisciplinary and a multidisciplinary field where a lot of overlap happens. थोड़ा engineering होता है, थोड़ा art होता है, थोड़ा tech होता है, culture होता है, human behavior होता है, psychology होता है. But traditionally, design has been sort of siloed into product design, graphic design, etc. Animation, filmmaking, वगैरह वगैरह. But what we're trying to do is have this overlap of all of these fields. Our course is called Humanizing Technology. It's a bachelor's in design. Design and humanizing technology. And what we aim to do is to keep the human at the center of things. Because technology badalte rehta hai. Something else, 5 years from now, it will be something else again. We are changing faster and faster. What is staying constant is the person using it. They have hopes and dreams and intentions and needs and requirements, which will always be similar. So you keep the user, the human, the person at the center and design around them. And that is the idea behind here. And to that intent, we have our program is a mix of technology, of sociology, of psychology, of visual and communication design, as well as product design and industrial design. Space experience design are also modules we cover. We do work and we do connected environments and IoT work.
Okay.
So, everything is sort of part of this. So no area goes untouched and then the student can choose what area they want to go deeper in after that.
Okay.
So that is the essential thrust of what our course and our college is like.
Okay. So psychology, then the sociology also?
Yes.
And
so we have modules that teach culture and cultural implications.
Okay.
Modules that teach about human behavior and psychology.
Okay. Psychology, sociology, art, and then culture studies.
Yes.
Okay.
We also have technology.
Technology.
Coding and we have electronics as well in the same set of modules.
Okay.
Okay. So we teach coding, we teach electronics, we teach connected technologies like IoT, VR, and how the psychology will affect someone in VR and how behavioral changes will happen when you use a connected data system. All of those interconnections are what we are playing at.
Okay. This is very interesting, like how technology is behaving with humans and how humans are behaving with technology. So there is a famous course I think it is in US, human computer interaction. Is it similar to that, or humanizing technology is much different than HCI?
So HCI and HMI are existing fields of study and research. Those are, as you said, it's a human computer interface or a machine interface. So at a very practical level, say on the undergrad level, their thrust would be more about control panels and systems and interface. But when you say humanizing technology, we come to that. But I think we look at it from a wider perspective. It's not just the interface, the junction where the person interacts with the technology. How the person and the technology, and how that junction can be either enriched or maybe even taken away.
Okay. And you also teach students the traditional design disciplines like graphics or videos or whatever,
yeah, so,
user research or user interface design.
Absolutely. So we do have modules for interface design. We have and we have all the basic stuff. So sketching has to be taught, and model making and all of those things are there in the foundation.
Okay.
So all of those disciplines are geared towards the aim of humanizing technology. So we don't teach filmmaking to make films. We will teach filmmaking to tell the story.
Oh, filmmaking for telling the story.
And the story is still humanizing technology.
Okay. Got it. So this is very interesting. This is multidisciplinary. Design is multidisciplinary, and it is at the intersection of multiple fields, right?
Yes.
So when it comes to NMIMS Design School, so they are offering B design.
Yeah,
Bachelor of Design, Humanizing Technology. Is there a master's course available?
We don't have one yet. We are still working on it. As we said, we are a new school, so we are still getting our feet firmly planted before we can start to plan.
Okay. What about open courses? Like if I want to do a design course, is there a MOOC available, or is there a short-term course available?
So far, we don't have anything like that, but we do keep holding speaker sessions.
Okay.
We invite people from the industry to come and talk to our students, and those will be open. Occasionally, we will have events where conferences or conventions happen.
Okay.
We had community events that happened in the past year before we opened. So those are open to people. We don't have courses yet, but that might change because of the situation we are in.
Okay. Because of the pandemic, how has it affected on the course?
Thankfully, we didn't. Obviously, we had to cancel the exams. The final exam had to be tossed off. But we had internal assessments, so we expanded on those. And because we are a very interactive course where it's a lot of face-to-face work, in the sense that it's a very process-oriented thing. We don't deliver theory and forget it. So most of the content had been delivered. There was a lot of mentoring that we had to do by March.
Okay.
Mr. ended. So that mentoring went online, and I think that went off well enough.
Okay.
The modules that were still teaching actual theory were also carried off fine. So we generally transitioned well enough, but there is obviously challenges where instead of delivering say theoretical content or stuff, if you have to teach something like sketching or modeling, that obviously can't happen online. So we are working our way through it.
Okay.
I think that's like everyone else at this point.
Yeah, right. So whatever needs a physical space or physical interaction, like you also have a maker space. So machine work has been stopped,
exactly. But
everything else has been converted into online mode.
Yeah. And we even got some students to work from home on physical models as well, based on what materials they had. And obviously they all have kits that they've taken home. So some of the stuff worked out that way. And then there's a lot of materials at home and in the kitchen, stuff where you use to do things.
Okay.
So, question of identifying what's possible.
That is a very interesting point. Materials in the kitchen or materials available at home. Could you give some example, like one or two examples of that? Ki kya kar sakte hai hum log isme ghar pe baith ke kya kar sakte?
So, ek student ka project tha jisme model banana zaruri tha. एंड वो जो शेप था वो एसेंशियल था उसका.
अच्छा.
एंड वो बनाने के लिए फिर उसने हम लोग ने सजेशंस दिए, तो उसने फिर न्यूज़पेपर पल्प और स्ट्रिप का पेपर मेश करके मॉडल बनाया. एंड इट पहली बार बनाया तो इट वॉजन वेरी ग्रेट, बट वो जो आइडिया था वो कम्युनिकेट हो गया, विच इज द पॉइंट टू क्रिएट यू नो फाइन एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ फिनिश्ड ऑब्जेक्ट्स. बट द कम्युनिकेशन होना चाहिए कि ये ऐसा होता है, इधर आएगा ऐसे जाएगा.
ओके
इट इज इनफ.
ओके ओके. सो
देन
सिंपल मटेरियल्स आल्सो यू कैन प्ले अराउंड विद मटेरियल्स एंड यू कैन मेक थिंग्स.
एंड फिर एक सीनियर ईयर का प्रोजेक्ट था वेयर दे हैड टू डू ट्रैफिक एनालिसिस. तो ग्रुप प्रोजेक्ट था, तो जिसका घर यू नो टॉप ऑफ द बिल्डिंग था उसका बालकनी से वो लोग वीडियो खींचते रहे और वही वीडियोस को एनालाइज करके उसका पूरा प्रेजेंटेशन दिया. सो व्हाट इज पॉसिबल, यू जस्ट हैव टू ओपन योर आईज.
सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फॉर ऑल द टीचर्स वॉचिंग दिस सेशन. Why? Because this is the way how design school conducts their assessments, right? तो अगर हमें स्कूल एग्जाम में भी अगर असेसमेंट्स को रीइमेजिन करना है या फिर आपके कॉलेजेस में असेसमेंट को रीइमेजिन करना है तो मे बी यू कैन टेक सम इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम अ डिजाइन स्कूल. तो द वे दे कंडक्ट असेसमेंट इज वेरी वेरी डिफरेंट. दे आर सब्जेक्टिव, दे आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन पर्सन, राइट?
या
So, could you just elaborate a bit on assessment part?
So, traditionally what we do, especially in our Indian education system, कि ये, you know, questions है, इसका यही है, ये question का ये answer होता है, और कुछ नहीं हो सकता. There's only one correct answer.
Right.
And according to how much of that you hit, उतना marks मिलता है.
Hmm.
In design, because we are looking at new stuff, there are no right answers.
Hmm.
Okay, even in the real world, there are no right answers. There are multiple ways के ऐसे भी जा सकते हैं, ऐसे भी जा सकते हैं, ऐसे भी पकड़ सकते हैं, ऐसे भी पकड़ सकते हैं. पहुंचना है उतना बहुत है.
Hmm.
आसानी से पहुंचे या नहीं पहुंचे, ठीक से पहुंचे, and you know that whole process, that is what is important.
Right.
तो वो वीडियो उसने रास्ते से नहीं लिया, बालकनी से लिया, is not important. उसका analysis हुआ, उसका insight मिला और वो आगे बढ़ा. That is important.
Okay.
So we have to be very outcome oriented कि ये हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है, कैसे हो रहा है, अलग अलग तरीकों से हो सकता है.
So this is not something like answer the following करके कि define this, define that, वो वाले
answers. We have no theory.
Okay.
We have apart from psychology and sociology, we have no subjects. उसमें भी activities होता है.
Okay.
बाकी सारा project work होता है, submissions होता है,
applications
होता है. क्वेश्चन पेपर्स, आंसर पेपर्स हम लोग होते ही नहीं है.
होते ही नहीं है. ओके. सो जो भी है वो असाइनमेंट के अराउंड है, प्रोजेक्ट बेस्ड सबमिशंस है, राइट?
यस. सो लाइक आर्किटेक्चर एंड डिजाइन वी हैव ज्यूरी पैनल्स.
हां,
फैकल्टी बैठेंगे या इंडस्ट्री से, अगर सीनियर प्रोजेक्ट है तो इंडस्ट्री से कोई आया होगा, वो बैठेंगे एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर होंगे, प्रेजेंटेशन होगा, साथ में क्रिटिक होगा. वो थ्योरी ये सवाल है उसका जवाब लिखो नहीं होगा.
ओके. ग्रेट. वो एक बहुत बड़ी लर्निंग है अपने एजुकेशन सिस्टम में फॉर ऑल द स्कूल्स हियर, ऑल द यू नो ऑल टीचर्स हियर. दे कैन प्लान देयर असेसमेंट इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट वे, टेकिंग इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम डिजाइन. नाउ आई वांट टू नो अबाउट जैसल मेहता. दिस इज इनफ अबाउट नरसिम्हन जी स्कूल ऑफ डिजाइन. नाउ व्हाट इज जैसल मेहता अप टू?
Jaisal Mehta is on a journey as usual, but so I am, my undergrad was an engineer. I have trained as an engineer.
Yeah.
I worked for a bit and then I went and did a postgrad in design. That's where my journey to design started. Maybe started before that actually. That's why I came and did that course. But since then I have worked in lighting for quite a while. I have worked in healthcare projects and right now I'm exploring computational design and using generative art. So basically it's stuff where you don't set up, you don't create the solution, you set up the parameters within which the solution appears, and it could be multiple correct solutions that criteria. Then but on the other hand, I am also these days very interested in how behavior and systems and culture interplay with each other, because as a designer, that becomes very evident in your work, that because you know people are at the center of everything, right? So behavior kaise hota hai, culture kahan se aata hai, culture ka kya hota hai behavior pe, that sort of thing. So that is my journey so far. I've been teaching for about 2 years now at School of Design. And I used to take a lot of workshops in digital fabrication at the spaces in Bombay. And that's about it.
Okay, great. If you can define what is design for in a layman's term. ठीक है, this is not for you or this is not for your students. This is for the student, a school student hearing, listening to this, or a school teacher listening to this. I want to know what is design.
Okay, so design can be a very broad term and can be a very narrow term depending on who you ask. But at its most basic, design is an intention.
Okay.
Okay, आपका इरादा क्या है? ये मुझे ये सॉल्व करना है.
Okay.
यहाँ से यहाँ पहुँचना है. इसको इसका ये बनाना है. मेरे को आपके सब्जी बनाना है is also an intention.
ठीक है.
It's the design.
Okay.
Okay, I need to plan my day so that I can meet 7 people, still get other work done. My timetable is my design. In a way, everyone is a designer at its most basic, because we are human beings. We are built to solve problems and we are built to have intentions. So design at its most basic is to have an intention and to have a plan to get that intention executed.
Okay.
So if
having
I need
a plan to get intention executed. So whatever you have in mind, if you are executing that, then you are going through a design process.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, you were saying something.
हाँ, तो मतलब मॉडर्न डिजाइन सेंस में यू नो यू द आईफोन इज डिजाइन एंड द फ्रिज इज अ डिजाइन एंड द हैंड ब्लेंडर इज अ डिजाइन द पियानो वाज अ डिजाइन सो ऑल ऑफ दोज आर आल्सो डिजाइन यस इन द मॉडर्न सेंस ऑफ डिजाइन बट दोज आर आल्सो प्रॉब्लम्स दैट देयर क्रिएटर्स हैव सॉल्वड आई नीड अ कम्युनिकेशन डिवाइस दैट विल डू दिस 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 और वो इतनी ही बैटरी में होना चाहिए इतने स्क्रीन पे ही होना चाहिए वो गाड़ी इतने में ही एक्सपेंसिव होनी चाहिए फिर भी इतना माइल्स चलनी चाहिए इतना किलोमीटर गैस पेट्रोल पे चलनी चाहिए सो दोज आर द इंटेंशंस
हां
दे सॉल्वड इट एंड दैट वाज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ डिजाइन सो डिजाइन इज अ प्रोसेस इट्स नॉट अ थिंग इट्स अ प्रोसेस इट्स अ जर्नी
ओके डिजाइन इज अ जर्नी वेयर यू सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स और यू कम अप विद अ डिफरेंट आइडिया एंड यू क्रिएट समथिंग सो दीज आर टू एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ डिजाइन राइट वन इज क्रिएटिंग समथिंग and another is solving an solving a certain problem
so you solve the problem by probably creating something
okay and right. There is one term associated which is wicked problems with design so what is that
so wicked problems again definitions vary but wicked problems are problems where you know it's not a simple ke acha how do I get from here to you know place A to place B you go down that road and pahunch jaoge it's not as simple if you say wicked problems are usually big problems like what we are right now the pandemic we have lockdown bhai lockdown nahi kiya to disease will spread
right
people will suffer lockdown kiya hai to economy suffering and people will suffer
right
kahin pe kiya hai kahin pe nahi kiya hai to it has its own set of problems
right
but people are not following is a problem why are people not following kyunki some people are desperate for their livelihood some people are just bored at home kyunki abhi 2 mahina ho gaya 3 mahina ho gaya so the whole managing a lockdown or managing a pandemic is a wicked problem because everyone has issues with someone else's solution I am fine with sitting at home but my maid is not
Yeah.
My maid wants to come and work, but I am not fine with that.
Right.
You know.
Got it.
I mean, it's not anti, but one person's problem is another person's solution, and it doesn't work. Something like that is a wicked problem where you have to really think and try to get a solution that is in between. Nobody will be very happy, but everyone will be okay with it. It's difficult.
Okay. So wicked problems are the problems where solutions are not straight. They are not straight line problems. They just go tangle and tangle. Like either say, if you are introducing one solution, then also you are affecting another.
Exactly.
So go wale wicked problems. So is education a wicked problem?
Absolutely.
Why? How?
Any system that works at such a large scale is inevitably a wicked problem, because what the student wants is something, what the parents want their children to have is something, what the teachers want to do is something, what the administrators need is something, what the government wants to put as a policy for the future of the country is something. So the factors at play are very large and very interconnected.
Right. So education.
There's a parent. There's a student, there's a parent, there's a teacher, there's a school admin, college admin, there's a government, say there is economics at play, there is culture at play. Okay? In some places, like economics at play, you need midday meals to get people to come in.
Yeah.
Works in some areas, doesn't work in some areas.
Right.
You will have cultural things where in some places you still have certain people can't walk with certain people. There are cultures, there are all of those issues. So, वहाँ कैसे होगा? So, all of this mix up makes it a wicked problem.
Okay. So education being a wicked problem, there are so many stakeholders involved. There are so many problems associated with education, right? So now you tell me, like, how design can enter into education and how can we look at education from a designer's perspective? And what can we do to solve educational problems?
Sorry, can you repeat that? You dropped out in between.
Oh, okay. So I'm saying education being a wicked problem, how can we look at education from a designer's perspective? ठीक है? Or if we can do something about solving education problem, where does design come into picture?
So design thinking is, as you said, a buzzword these days, but it's actually it's trend, but designers have been doing it. Architects have been doing it, and other practitioners who are involved in that line of thought have been doing it for quite a while now.
Okay.
And what it helps you do, it's a very simple overall process. So, uska actual application will change situation to situation. The process looks at how to solve a problem in a very holistic way. Ke pehle you have to sort of figure out ki problem kya hai. Jo problem hai, wo hota nahi hai. उसके पीछे का क्या होता है, दैट इज द इशू. सो दैट प्रोसेस दैट यू फॉलो ऑफ, यू फाइंड आउट, यू रिसर्च इनटू एन एरिया, यू डिग डीपर इनटू इट, यू फाइंड आउट व्हाट द रियल प्रॉब्लम इज, देन यू हैव सम आइडियाज अबाउट यू नो हाउ टू सॉल्व इट, एंड देन यू टेस्ट दोज आइडियाज, क्रिएट सम प्रोटोटाइप, यू क्रिएट सम टेस्टिंग जोन वेयर यू ट्राई इट आउट, अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट और समथिंग, टेस्ट इट, एंड देन यू लर्न फ्रॉम दैट टेस्ट.
राइट.
एंड वंस यू लर्न फ्रॉम दैट टेस्ट, व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट, व्हाट इज द फीडबैक, you go back to the beginning or you go back to somewhere in between and apply that learning and then repeat this. And that cyclic process is what the core of the design process, that there is a feedback loop.
Okay.
और वो हो गया doesn't end there. वो हो गया, उसके आगे क्या हुआ? ये जो हुआ उससे हम लोग what can we learn? उसको वापस change कैसे कर सकते? और वो change करने के बाद उसका जो साइकल्स, मल्टीपल साइकल्स जाता है, एंड देन एट द एंड ऑफ इट यू माइट से कि हां नाउ दिस इज 90% सॉर्टेड. सो दैट इज द कोर ऑफ द डिजाइन प्रोसेस, एंड दैट एंड फीडबैक इज व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट पार्ट.
ओके. सो बेसिकली यू टेक अ प्रॉब्लम एंड यू आइडिएट अबाउट सॉल्यूशन, देन यू प्रोटोटाइप समथिंग, यू कम अप विद अ सॉल्यूशन. And you test the solution, come back.
Huh.
Okay.
Test the solution, you learn what is working and what is not working. So the idea is not to have the correct solution in the first shot. The idea is to learn from your own solution.
Okay. There, sorry, I missed your point.
I said one shot mein nahi hota hai.
Huh.
Wo repeated practice se hota hai. Repeated learning from your mistakes is the core of it.
Okay. So that means it is an iterative process. It has a feedback loop.
Yes.
Right. तो अगर आपको कुछ एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड प्रॉब्लम है तो हम उसे डिजाइन के नजरिए से कैसे देखेंगे, दैट्स व्हाट वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन इन द नेक्स्ट एड्यूथॉन. एंड जेसल एंड द स्कूल ऑफ डिजाइनिंग डिजाइन NMIMS स्कूल ऑफ डिजाइन आर नॉलेज पार्टनर्स विद अस. दे आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ टेकिंग यू थ्रू द प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग प्रोसेस, राइट? सो जेसल, देर इज वन कंफ्यूजन. There is one design, you call something as design, and there is one buzzword which is design thinking. Now, are they connected or they are different, or like what it is exactly?
So as I said, a lot of people, especially marketing and MBAs, tend to have taken over this term these days. So all the MBA programs now have design thinking.
Yeah.
Something that designers have been doing since day minus one or something, but of course they are connected for sure. Design and design thinking. Design thinking lets you do design, and design involves design thinking to begin with.
Yeah,
so they are connected, but what people mean by it varies. So sometimes a lot of people just call the design process as design thinking, but for designers, that's the process. That's how it works. So it's not special in the sense that this is the holy grail of solutions. Is just how we operate by default.
Okay, so design thinking.
अगर center में होना चाहिए is common sense for us. कि जिसके लिए तुम design कर रहे हो, उसका तो ख्याल करो.
Okay, okay. So design thinking is a thinking mindset.
Yes.
Okay. And design is a process.
Yes.
So are there any other frameworks, like there is 5-step design thinking framework given by Stanford D School and IDEO, right? Which almost everybody is following that framework. So are there any other frameworks which we can look at?
So most other frameworks stem from that. So instead of the 5 steps, it becomes 8 steps because some steps are split up into more details. Some steps are not. Okay. And depending on what industry you're looking at, there are areas which will have far more detail and certain areas which will not.
Okay.
So if say you look at UX and UI design, software and IT ka influence zyada hai, to some areas are far more detailed. Ta nahi hoga, but testing bahut zyada hota hai. Testing parameters alag alag hota hai. Whereas for something like say furniture design, the variation will have a lot of depth, but testing is, as long as it works, it's working, it's simple. Okay. So that variation happens. Also, while it is seen to be a linear process, it is not. It's a very chaotic process that eventually streamlines, as we will see in the workshop that I'll take. Okay, it's not like step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and ho gaya. It piche upar niche sideways and then finally wo funnel hoke banta hai.
Okay, okay, got it. Okay. So with respect to education, there is one designer, not even designer, he is a faculty of design as well, Pramod Khadilkar. So he is saying project-based learning also needs theory. He says he's not very... a doctorate in design, he is saying that project-based learning also needs theory.
Yes.
He is not really convinced with not having theory in project-based learning.
So, in what context?
The context which we were, I think it is regarding assessment, which we were discussing at the beginning of the session.
So, yeah, okay. In context of what we do at the School of Design, we do have theory. It's not like we don't have theory.
Hmm.
But the theory gets applied. The theory is not tested ke iska definition kya hai. The theory is tested ke has this worked and have you applied it correctly? If you applied it correctly, you understood what it is.
So, this is only with respect to assessment that you are not taking theory in account. Maybe this is applied theory in assessment.
Yeah, we are absolutely teaching theory.
Okay.
We are absolutely teaching theory. There is no question there. So subjects like sociology and psychology have a lot of theory. Even tech and coding and all of those will have certain principles and theory attached to it. But we don't based on just the theoretical knowledge. It's a very practical, hands-on thing.
Okay. I think that clears a lot of doubt regarding project-based learning and also from the assessment part, teach theory, but don't test based on theory. Test based on the application of theory.
Right.
Are there any more questions? We would certainly like to take questions. Why? Because this is a design, this is a session on design. We really don't want
to thrive on interaction.
Right. So it should be an interactive session. If I want to ask you from an educator's point of view, like, let's say I'm a student. Okay. I'm a student of 8th, 9th, 10th grade, or even in engineering college, like I was in engineering college long back. So how can I apply design in my context?
So you can, so this whole, you know, intention based, once you know why you need to do something, or once you, even if you don't know why you need to do something and you dig into it and you ask, why am I doing this? Ask yourself or ask your teachers or ask your whoever is around. You understand the why, then you automatically have an idea of what needs to be done and how it has to go around. Ki ye sahi hai ya galat hai ya appropriate hai ya nahi hai. Okay, so the why is important, and once you know ke mera target ye hai, then that tends to open your mind ke aisa nahi hota to aise bhi chalega, ye nahi hoga wo bhi ho jayega.
Okay,
so that opening up of your mind ke nahi, there is not just one single road to do it.
Hmm.
I think the most important learning, and then of course the whole, you know, getting a deeper level of understanding into things is what you know, design research first of all gives you. And once you get an understanding, then you obviously start looking at things differently and understanding things differently.
Okay. So, पहले तो मुझे ये पूछना है कि मैं जो कर रही हूँ, मैं जो पढ़ रही हूँ, वो मैं क्यों पढ़ रही हूँ.
हाँ.
सबसे important.
Yes.
उसके बाद में ये मेरे life में उसका practically क्या significance है, वो right. मुझे देखना पड़ेगा. और हाँ. अगर question है, तो वो question मैं कैसे solve करूँ.
Right.
ये तीन चीजें important है according to you. Okay. The next thing, you spoke about design research.
Right.
So what is design research? Like, if I'm an educator, how can design research help me to design my learning experiences?
So if you are an educator, if you are a teacher, or if you are a principal, if you're some administrator, your research basically will dig into who are your stakeholders.
Hmm.
Right. So your parents, who need their child to, you know, grow up and be successful by whatever parameters of successful means. Hmm. You have a child who wants to learn, but also wants to have fun, who also wants to look to a secure future with interesting things to do, etc. And, you know, then there are the other stakeholders. You have your staff who need, who are doing the teaching in the classroom, but they also have certain needs and necessities. Ke, you know, they need certain resources, or they need certain times, or they need space, whatever. And then you have the non-teaching staff. You'll have local government bodies, all of those things. And so your design research will first tell you what each of these people expect from the education.
Hmm.
Okay, so these are all your stakeholders. What each stakeholder expects is one thing you will learn. And why are the expectations not being met right now? Or if they're being met, what are the parameters which are successful? So what is working? What is not working? Why is it not working? Why is it working? All that analysis is design research.
Okay.
So that's essential overview of the system, or not even an overview. It's a deep dive into the system.
Okay. So one question is, what are design aspects of curriculum and curricular transactions?
So I don't think I'm the correct person to answer that. I am a designer who is educating, not an educator who is designing.
Okay. So I think we can take that up. What are the design aspects of curriculum? Curriculum is one thing. Curriculum is for whom? Which kind of school or which kind of learner is involved in the curriculum? That we need to understand. And then what are their requirements? Where are they coming from? So we, if we can talk about that, then maybe we can design a curriculum, right? So what are their needs and where are you taking them to? Does that make sense, Jason?
Yeah, it does.
And about the curricular transactions, I think you will be the best person because you are also teaching. So what are the design aspects of curricular transactions?
What do you mean by curricular transactions?
Curricular transaction is a term in education where you are saying, ki, acha, main agar padha raha hun. Transaction is about the pedagogy or teaching methodology. But this curricular transaction is an umbrella term for turning this curricular objectives in reality. But let's say we are sticking here to teaching learning methodology. Then how?
So as I said, as I gave that example, ke, we had a project where they needed to do a traffic plan analysis for whatever reason they were doing it. And so our assessment was very outcome based. It was like whatever the methodology they used, but finally it was their outcome that we tested. So that's I think one thing we are looking at, that as long as there is an outcome that is defined in the beginning, the teacher, the facilitator knows what they're aiming for. And then it's at the end, it's tested. Ke ye hua hai ki nahi. Not about knowledge transfer. It's about learning. It's actually about learning and understanding data and information.
Okay. So basically, if you want to see if learning has been transacted to the learner, then right. Design comes into picture. Basically, it is what they are learning, how they are learning, and the thing is if they have learned or not.
Yeah.
And take that as a feedback and right. Design your process, learning,
exactly.
Teaching process. Okay.
Yeah. So for the next batch, we will again tweak our process. It's never the same process. So if one batch has worked out in a certain way, then those learnings we also apply to the next batch. Okay. Wo batch, matlab, aisa hua and that exercise did not really work. This exercise worked well. So we'll do more of this kind, but not that kind. Or we'll change that exercise so that it works better.
Right.
So that learning and feedback and iteration happens in our actual teaching as well.
Right. So learning, so ideation, feedback, and the prototyping part all happens in your teaching also. Similarly, with curriculum, with his previous question about the design aspect of curriculum. So ideation on what should be there in the curriculum and what problem are we going to solve regarding the curriculum? Like when we are sitting together to decide what goes into curriculum of Eduthon, then also we are identifying the needs and then we are ideating on what is going in the curriculum and how it should go. Okay, he's still there. He has just stopped the video. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, then let us know. Okay, I think there is some technical issue with Jaisal. That's why he is offline right now. But so when we talk about design, we have to talk about the person who the persona or person who is impacted with your project or while deciding your ideas or problem statements also in the next Eduthon. What we are looking at is whom are you solving for rather than what problem are you solving. What problem comes later, but whom are you solving for? Then what problem are you solving? What are they going through? ठीक है, एक तो होता है अपना problem वाला statement, लेकिन अगर लेकिन actual problem क्या है उसको समझना है, then the design research comes into picture. So if you want to apply design process for education related problem solving, then also you will have to look at these aspects. ठीक है, अगर मुझे एक स्टूडेंट के लर्निंग पे काम करना है, देन हाउ एम आई गोइंग टू डू इट, लाइक व्हाट काइंड ऑफ स्टूडेंट, क्या इकोसिस्टम है स्टूडेंट का, फिर क्या प्रॉब्लम है स्टूडेंट के पीछे, मतलब बैकग्राउंड में क्या क्या चीजें चल रही है, दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, सो जेसल इज सेइंग दैट ही विल कम बैक इन अ मिनट बिकॉज हिज लैपटॉप गॉट हैंग. टिल देन आई थिंक वी कैन टॉक अबाउट करिकुलर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ डिजाइन और डिजाइन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ करिकुलम. सो करिकुलम डिजाइन में इफ यू आर ओके, जेसल इज अगेन बैक. Hey Jaisal.
Hi, I'm so sorry. I think I didn't touch the laptop for a while, so it just hung up.
Acha, acha. No problem, no problem. So we were talking about design aspects of curriculum. So I was just saying ki underlying issues kya hai? Like who is the learner and what are their underlying issues? Wo we need to identify and then come up with a real problem statement. Then only solution come, right?
If you go by the you know, design philosophy, the first question is why. Even before the who and the what is the why. Why do you need to do this?
Okay.
Why are we educating our children, or why are we educating our adults for that matter? That okay. question and the answer to that question is your guiding light.
Okay.
Once you are clear on why certain things have to be done, then you know, okay, ye sahi hai ya galat hai, does it lead to your intention or does it not lead to your intention?
Okay. So, in education particularly, so you can use design for curriculum design, developing curriculum, developing your content, designing your teaching learning method, teaching method of teaching, right?
Right. Yeah.
That is also there. Then what else? Like assessments we discussed.
Right.
What else comes in education which we can do, apply design?
So from anything as small as your classroom exercise, say like an entire policy, can the same process applies, and design thinking can go everywhere, where whether it's an exercise and you need to make sure ke wo 1+1 aata hai ki nahi hai, and ye kya kya kar sakte hai, how many different ways can you teach them that 1+1 is 2, and then what addition means, and then have, you know, multiple prototypes and testing and all of that. Say national education policy, and how many different ways can you make sure that literacy is increasing, or that women's literacy is you know, above a certain benchmark, or any of those intentions, and then how, you know, what are the different ways to achieve that, kaunsa policy, what features, what provisions, what subsidies. So at all levels, whether it's a single classroom exercise to a national or global education policy, the process in its essence remains the same. In its application will change according to the past.
Okay. Let's say I'm a teacher and I want to conduct, let's say, maths class. ठीक है?
Right.
मुझे किस-किस चीज़ की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी? एक तो maybe मुझे textbook की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी, मुझे कुछ materials की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी, right?
Right.
हाँ. और फिर मुझे कुछ तो एक content लगेगा. So for all this, can I use design? Like, let's say I want to develop teaching learning material.
Right.
So can I use design for that?
Yes.
For so, any subject?
For any subject. So say you have to teach history.
Hmm.
You know, you have to teach history because you need, say you need students to understand what their, you know, what the history of your culture is. So because that tells you why certain things are what they are today.
Okay. Now,
that you can then say ke mere ko drama karna hai, mere ko skit karna hai, mere ko storytelling karna hai, need a table of dates, or do I need a map of how a war happened, or any other way. So once you know why you need to do something, you can apply different ways to get there. So the moment you understand that there is no one right way, rasta sahi hai aisa nahi hota hai, alag alag raste try kar sakte.
Right.
So Panipat ka battle can be talked about, can be told a story about, can be told on a map, ke idhar se aise aaya, aise aaya, can be a chess game, can be anything. It's the teacher to figure what her students want. Students of one place will be different from students of the other place, and that teacher knows that.
Right.
That intimate knowledge is also a part of the deal.
Okay. So design आप कहीं भी लगा लीजिए, आपको material develop करना है या फिर कुछ भी करना है, assessment develop करना है, activity plan करनी है, फिर भी आप design process को use कीजिए. और तो design process में आप prototype बनाते हो, उसके बाद में test करते हो, prototype बनाते हो, test करते हो, तो 100% problem कभी solve हो सकती है?
नहीं, because there is always room for improvement.
Okay.
If I manage to teach Panipat successfully, it means के मैं World War II सिखाना है अभी मुझे. Right. तो, but there is an acceptable level where you say के हाँ इतना अच्छा है.
Okay.
So here is okay. You have a 90% solution. You'll never have 110. You'll never even have 100. But at 99, you can say के you are achieving all that was required. Your minimum requirements are 100% met, but there will always be room for improvement.
Okay. So this is a beautiful thought.
Nothing left to be done, never. But is enough done? Yes.
Okay. So this thought is itself is very beautiful. Ki we can't be 100% perfect, or things can't be 100% perfect. That is the philosophy of design, is it?
Yeah. The moment something is 100% perfect, it is outdated.
Because okay. Aisa kyun?
Because we are moving ahead, right? If I have taught something today which is now complete, tomorrow something else will happen which is more than that.
Okay.
So there is always room for improvement even if you have stopped.
Okay. So isi mindset ke saath hame hamesha chalna padega. Design agar life mein use karna hai to, ki hamesha there is room for improvement and there is always something new happening.
Yeah.
Great.
Enough between how much is enough, how much is there room for improvement, and you choose where you land between those two. मतलब एकदम कम में भी enough हो गया ऐसा नहीं चलेगा. 100% aim किया तो वो उतना resource, उतना time, effort could be used to make something else much better than to capture that last 5% of this.
Okay, great. So this was a beautiful conversation. और बाकी और भी चीजें हैं जो हम आपसे सीखेंगे और स्कूल ऑफ डिजाइन से भी सीखेंगे आने वाले कुछ दिनों में. सो आप हमारे नॉलेज पार्टनर है फॉर द नेक्स्ट एड्यूथॉन. NMIMS डिजाइन स्कूल इज द नॉलेज पार्टनर एंड यू आर वर्किंग वेरी क्लोजली विद अस फॉर क्रिएटिंग करिकुलम फॉर डिजाइन पार्ट, राइट? सो could you brief on that, like थोड़ा सा अगर आप बता देंगे उसके बारे में कि हम क्या-क्या सीखने वाले हैं आने वाले दिनों में.
So आने वाले दिनों में once learning phase अभी चालू होगा, so we will essentially have two webinars, one on the design process जो हम लोग अभी discuss किए कि what are the different steps and how they interrelate, इसमें आगे पीछे क्या होता है, sidewise जाके prototyping होता है, testing होता है, फिर backwards वापस learning होता है. So that design process पे एक webinar होगा और एक डिजाइन थिंकिंग पे वेबिनार होगा वेर आई विल टेक यू थ्रू डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ थिंकिंग. यू नीड टू एनालाइज एंड समटाइम्स यू नीड टू क्रिटिसाइज एंड समटाइम्स यू नीड टू जस्ट जंप साइडवाइज एंड से ऐसा नहीं ऐसा होता है. एंड समटाइम्स यू नीड टू जूम आउट एंड से ये तो मैं इतना देख रहा हूँ पर ये बड़े पिक्चर में क्या है. सो ऑल ऑफ दोज डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ थिंकिंग इज डिजाइन थिंकिंग वेबिनार. द डिजाइन प्रोसेस वेबिनार इज फॉर द प्रोसेस.
ओके. So, ये वेबिनार तो है लेकिन मेंटरिंग भी अवेलेबल है.
एब्सोल्युटली.
सो
वंस द लर्निंग फेज चालू हो रहा है, आइडिएशन चालू हो रहा है, तभी ऑल ऑफ द मेंटर्स विल बी अवेलेबल टू द ग्रुप्स एंड टू द थीम्स. तो इफ यू आर इन द आइडिएशन फेज एंड यू नीड सम गाइडेंस और यू नीड सम चेकिंग के क्या हो रहा है, इज दिस करेक्ट और नॉट, और इफ यू आर स्टक, सो द मेंटरिंग इज ऑल्सो ऑलवेज अवेलेबल एंड वी आर देयर टू हेल्प फॉर दैट.
ग्रेट. So thank you so much, Jaisal. By chance, if anybody has missed our Facebook live sessions, we are also uploading videos on YouTube, on YouTube channel of Makeshift. Ruchira will share the link. If there are any questions or comments, please let us know so that we can take it up in next 2 minutes. Otherwise, we will wind up this session. And this was a beautiful session on design. This is the perfect timing, and the topic is also so interesting, and this next edutron is coming up, so there are so many problems that we are, you know, getting on everyday basis. People are submitting their problem statements, right? So this is going to be a very interesting journey with all of you, and
we are really looking forward to it, because it is something that is needed right now, and it is something that is needed for our country as well, as our education system, as our, and all the challenges we are grappling through today, especially today. So we are absolutely looking forward to it, and we are happy to be here.
Thanks a lot. Thank you, Jaisal. Thanks to all of you who are watching this. So we'll catch up soon with Jaisal again.
Definitely.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye-bye.